I am pleased to welcome you all to this second Centenary International Conference. I am sure you are going to enjoy this 2 days conference and also going to enjoy your stay. Here, I would like to draw your attention to what India is in a brief 2 to 3 lines. Over the last decades, 3 decades, there's not been much change in the intakes in Indian diets, except for marginal increase in fats and very minimal dietary diversity. And coming to PDS system, public distribution system, the people who are not covered under PDS have better dietary diversity compared to people who are under government PDS system. Now, recently, most of you must be aware of that the FAO, UN organization, has stated, has released a report saying that dietary factors are posing a greater risk than infectious diseases such as tuberculosis, malaria, measles, etc. And they also go on to state that healthy foods will curtail the expenditure that we meet with industrial fortification to meet the micronutrient requirements. And here they say that 1 out of 5 deaths was associated with dietary, healthy diets and poor diets. So here when we look at the NSSO data, what we do see is the intake of fruits and vegetables is extremely poor. We in India consume only 30 grams of fruits per day and about 100 to 150 grams vegetables per day across sections, right from poor as well as rich people. And even these fruits and vegetables come from banana and potato. Potato is not the ideal vegetable, and banana is not, I mean, there should be diversity in fruits as well. Apart from NSSO, even the NFHS4 and NNMB diet also paint a very poor picture as far as dietary diversity is concerned across sections of population in India. And the recent analysis reported in September 2018 showed that the GPD across states of ETL states, that is epidemiological transition level, even the poor states, the age standardized prevalence of CVD diseases are increasing. And again here, I would like to state and emphasize the fact that unhealthy diet is tops the list of leading risk and leads the risk factors for CVDs. In the sense, 56% of the diabetes associated with CVDs can be attributed to unhealthy diet. Why? Air pollution and tobacco is contributing. Instance, we have tobacco control program in place, and as far as air pollution is concerned, we have this cooking fuel, clean cooking fuel on that is Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala program and also Swachh Bharat program. These programs are sure to make some impact as far as air pollution or household pollution is concerned and also tobacco use is concerned. But do we have any program in place to promote healthy diets in population is a question. So these programs are there, but one thing that the government and people must understand is these unhealthy diets which promote overweight, obesity and the related disorders like diabetes type 2 and cardiovascular diseases also promote undernutrition. The stunting that we see also is related to this. And also apart from overweight and obesity, these diets promote what is called thin fat. So apparently most of us appear thin and normal, but inside we accumulate fatty tissue in the liver, around the organs and also viscera. Again, this is promoted because of unhealthy diets. So here I look forward that this conference, which is timely aligning food system for healthy diets and improved nutrition, is very timely, and I look forward that we would come out with proper recommendation to improve access affordability to healthy diet. So towards this, I congratulate Mr. Longwa and his team for conducting this conference and wish all the best for the conference, and I'm sure we are going to come out with proper recommendation to improve healthy diets across different sections in India. Thank you.